Hey guys, JohnnyCrips2000 here, and welcome back to my Let's Play of the Simpsons game. This is part 3, and we are making our way over there to the light to get our next level. And next time we are going to get, I believe it's, we're going to get through, actually no, I think I remember. I'm trying to remember what level we're going to get into, but I think we have one more level with Homer and Bart here, and then we are going to get on with Marge and Lisa. So I don't think Marge or Lisa are going to show up in this part. I think we have one more level before we get to that. So if you're a fan of If you're a fan of Marge and Lisa, you're going to have to wait just a little bit longer. And I am completely lost. I thought I had found a shortcut here. Good lord, where am I? I'm just all kinds of lost. Okay, let's see if we can jump on top of this. No, apparently we can't. Damn it. Alright. Let's go ahead and, apparently I went completely the wrong way. Let's use the Homer ball here. I'm trying to get to the light source over there, but apparently that wasn't the way that I was supposed to go. And, darn it. I can't use boost anymore. When is they gonna make Kid Rock's birthday a national holiday? Okay, I think we have to go all the way around here. There we go. There we go. And there's Moe's, if you were wondering, and there's Cletus' house. Now, I don't think that this setup here for the city of Springfield, I don't think it's actually, canon. Like, I don't think Cletus's house is just right there in the middle of town. But like I said, the fun thing here is just seeing how much fan service they can put into a game, and it's not the biggest game, but it's still pretty awesome. And here we go with level 3. And this is around the world in 80 minutes or something like that. I can't remember. Roman incident. And I'm not exactly sure if this was based off of a previous episode or not, but again, these levels, hey, it's Stuffman. Oh yeah. And there's Bumblebee Man, Barney, and can't remember his name, damn it, comic book guy. We all know that one guy that's pretty much the same as comic book guy. And now, new objective. When you get to see this icon, press to-do list. Get Homer into Australia. Now, this game, or this level, rather, is rather different than any of the other levels that we've played before and any other levels that we will play afterwards. And I'm sorry if I'm... if I'm sort of not talking here, but I am trying to sort of keep focus here. The reason for it is because there is a lot to do in this level. So for example, in this part, I think that you can stick with one character, but I think there are certain parts where, yeah, there we go, where you can't. You have to keep switching back and forth between Homer and Bart in order to complete to get through to the next level or to the next country. I think that's Germany. This is France. And there's oh my God, what's his name? And he just drew up the drawbridge, so he's a tool. And then, all right. So I think for this part, we definitely need. I think we need Bart. Or not. No, yeah, we definitely need Bart. All right, so where's Bart? Bart. No, damn it. There we go. All right, so we need to get Bart over here. Bounce off of these. There we go. Turn into Bartman. There we go. And then take this. There we go. And I think we're going to have to climb the Eiffel Tower here. Or not. Just press this button. Now, you do have a timer, so there is sort of like an added stress, if you want to call it that, to this level. Now, what we have to do here is, I believe, yeah, we have to float all the way over here. Now, one of the things about this this level here is that you're constantly being put in a position where... Oh, I kind of... Oh, God. Homer's almost dead. All right, we're in Scotland now.
Scotland!
Oh, God, I'm never doing that again. All right, we have to get up here. And we need Homer. Oh, come on. There we go. And we need to get him... and his big fat ass, and we need to slam down on this this pipe. God, I'm so bad with words now, like I can't remember. There we go. And then we need to get Bart the bagpipe. That's what I meant. All right, so we need to get Bart up here. Let's go ahead and turn into Bartman. There we go. Ride the wind. Press this button. That'll lower the drawbridge there. Allow Homer to make his way over there. Now, the good thing about this game is that you don't have to control... Oh, okay. You don't have to control Homer all the time. Like your friends or whatever. Which is pretty cool. Italy, where noodles are called pasta and pasta is called super pasta. Okay, so let's go ahead and get... I think we need Homer. And... Booyah! There we go. Awesome, I just landed right there like a boss. Alright, so I think we need this. Let's climb this noodle. Make our way over here. Now, one of the annoying things about this game is that sometimes you'll like go into this level, like you'll keep proceeding through this level, and then you get to a part where you find out that, oh crap, I need to get Bart into this and not Homer, which then you have to, you know, you have to backtrack and stuff like that. Oh God, what did I do? Oh damn it! Okay, I think. Now the good thing too about this is that you do. I'm trying to remember, like where do I need, is that you do add time to your time limit there. Every time you enter a new country, you do add a little bit more time. Like for example, I'm at 10 minutes. I used to be at 8, I think. Alright, here we go. We're almost done with this level. This is a rather quick level, but it can be kind of annoying if you don't know what to do. Thankfully, I still remember, for the most part, what to do. So this might be a short part here, because I'm trying to get to the point where I'm doing only one level per part. As I said, these will get a little longer later on. They will get a little bit more complicated as we progressed, so... There we go. I don't know what that did. Oh, there it is. And where's Homer? There he is. Oh, come on. See, like, he's way back here. He needs to... That's one of the bad parts about this. Because your partner is computer-controlled, if you're not doing co-op, they tend to do things like this where it's like, you know, they're kind of not doing what they're supposed to do and that, you know, they're not following you. They're over there too busy beating up people, which normally is a good thing. You know, you want them to kind of help you out. Beating up people, but in this level, you can beat up the other characters, but it doesn't do anything. They have infinite lives, and this is amazing right here. Look at this. Holy crap, somebody paid to have this thing built.
I don't think I've ever seen such a beautiful sight.
Good Lord, America indeed. And this essentially works as boom, as a almost like a boss fight, if you will. Not really, but it does. Really, all you need to do is find these switches, pound on them, and it'll lower the barrier around the statue. And all you have to go is in front there. Ah, it's too late. There we go. And boom, you just have to find the hole, and it'll lower it. And it keeps doing that, and you can probably figure out what you have to do, you know, for the boss fight. So here's a nice little trick that you can do. The statue is spinning, so get it to where you can see the hole, and then all you can do is have to immediately just dash into it. What I failed to do before was wait. Was I failed to look at where the hole was before I pressed down on the button, so I couldn't find it. And oh crap!
Jeez, that was my choking hand. Still, you did great.
Makes no sense, but it's so funny. I wish Duffman was like a secret character. Oh yeah. With the red Barclay championship belt is last year's champion. And here's last year's champion. Which I think it's based off of the guy with the hot dog eating guy. I think his name is Kobayashi.
Hira, how did you win? You're so tiny.
Technique.
Yeah, there he is. I think his name is Kobayashi. I saw like specials and stuff on him.
The losers have to clean up. Oh yeah.
And I like this little reference right here. Wait for it. There he is.
You maniacs! You blew it up! Ah, damn you! God damn you! What the hell?
Nice little reference there. And that was it, guys. That was a pretty short level. I mean, the thing about this level is that it, I mentioned before, the first time that you play it, you're probably going to take a lot longer than I did. I just remembered more or less what to do. And as you guys see here, I didn't really take the time to go out and find all these things, which is unfortunate, especially in the form of, you know, with the cliches and stuff like that. I really like the cliches, so I really wish that we would have been able to find them. They tend to be funny, but again, that just goes into the replay value of this game. And I believe we are now going to get into... Yeah, there we go. So we unlocked Lisa. So I'm going to show her off just a little bit. And then I'm going to call it a day. So all we have to do is go to this bus stop. We can change our character. So let's make our main character Lisa, since she's unlocked. And our buddy is Bart, because that's who we need for our next level, if I remember correctly. Just wait for this thing to load, and now we are in control of Lisa. So Lisa is, she's just as fast as Bart. I don't know if either one of them is faster, but this, now we can collect these Malibu Stacy seals, find them all in each episode to unlock a trophy. So obviously that is her collectible, and her thing is, her special attack is actually, I think, probably the best one in the game, the best one out of the four playable characters. Basically what she does is, let's see if I can find somebody. As you guys see down there, she has a little saxophone with her, and obviously, as you can tell, her attacks are going to be based off of her saxophone. If we can find somebody to sort of show this off to.
Only 20 more years.
Now, I don't want to do it to Mrs. Grobobble, because, you know, she passed away and it's kind of sad. And let's get this seal here. As I said before, I'm not trying to get all of the seals, but it's kind of hard not to, you know.
Well, you're certainly doing your job today.
And that's
son.
If you break the fire hydrant, you'll get an updraft, so that's how you get on top of the building with Bart. This is Mole Man, I think that's his name. So let's test it out on him. If you press the B button, boosh, just like that. It stuns everybody around you, and it's actually a very good move. All things considered, especially when you get around to when you're surrounded and stuff. And the other thing that Lisa is able to do, I don't think I'm going to be able to show it off now because we haven't unlocked the move yet. We have to unlock the move in the levels themselves, but she also does this, is a Buddha statue, and again, I can't show it off just yet. We're going to have to wait until the next part, but let's just say that it's a very freaky looking thing, and it's freaky, but at the same time, it's awesome because it just shows you how awesome this thing looks. What's wrong with Lisa? She looks brain dead or something. But anyway, guys, that's it for part 3 of Let's Play the Simpsons game. I will see you in part 4, where we will find out what Lisa's, what she's able to do in this game. All right, so this has been Johnny Crimson 2000, and I will see you in my next part. All right, peace out.